Item number, SCP-482. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. SCP-482 was recovered during an experiment being conducted by Dr. Bright. After initial containment, SCP-482 was turned over to Dr. for documentation and analysis. Dr. Bright and Dr. are to be notified immediately should there be any changes to SCP-482. Or any duplicates found. While it is not being tested, SCP-482 is to be stored in containment locker located at site. Access to the locker is restricted to level 2 personnel and above. Such access, and all activities thereafter, are to be logged and recorded within 24 hours of completion. The maximum time limit for testing of SCP-482 is 1 hour after mutations manifest. All subjects who have reached or exceeded this point while in contact with SCP-482 are to be immediately terminated. Before autopsy and disposal, SCP-482 is to be recovered first and separated from the subject's body. Localized thermal cleansing protocol is then to be performed on the body after autopsy, and any biological samples or personnel deemed contaminated by the test subject. Description. SCP-482 is a black leather straitjacket of similar make to the brand. Although the jacket seems to be made for the medium size, testing has shown that it can fit most body sizes. Subjects with larger body types report, however, that they feel compressed or suffocated while wearing it. The words "Made in Shaoyan, China, hand wash only, no Asaragina powder" are present on the manufacturer's tag in faded text. Neither the factory nor the item Asaragina exist on any known records. Finally, while there are no obvious signs of wear and tear on the item, there are several small cuts on the straps. Analysis has shown that these could not have been inflicted by anyone wearing SCP-482. Testing has shown that while immune to any damage due to body changes occurred by the subject, it can be damaged by external forces, as normal for an object of this material. Further destructive testing on SCP-482 has been suspended due to the lack of viable duplicates. SCP-482 has two known effects, occurring in a linear fashion once the item is worn. These have been identified as time points Alpha and Beta. Experiments have shown that while the effects of time point Alpha fade after loss of contact with SCP-482, those inflicted by Beta are permanent. Time point Alpha refers to the initial stage of exposure to SCP-482. This exposure time lasts a varied period between 1 and 6 hours that a subject wears SCP-482. The item can be removed before Alpha elapses completely without ill effect. During this period, the subject feels mentally better. Any mental afflictions that the subject possesses, regardless of degree or intensity, are negated completely. Any medication being taken by the subject has its effects completely negated as well. Foundation standard psychological tests return results consistent with a baseline normal, mentally stable individual. Upon separation of the subject in SCP-482, the mental illnesses return in full force, along with the side effects of any medication. Multiple sessions wearing SCP-482 have continued effect, though any time in the suit contributes to the overall cumulative time until the subject reaches time point Beta. Time point Beta refers to the subsequent time period that passes if a subject is still wearing SCP-482 once Alpha lapses. During this period, the subject experiences physical mutation that seems to be determined by the nature of the subject's mental disorder. Should the subject have multiple mental illnesses, the mutations will manifest according to their degree of strength. See Experiment Log SCP-482 for recorded physical mutations observed during testing. Experiment Log SCP-482. Known mutations created by SCP-482 are listed in the document as follows. Test Number 1. Subject Gender: Male. Subject's known mental illness: Schizophrenia. Medication: None. Exposure: Alpha. Subject reported being eerily calm. subject was noted as simply sitting and looking at the walls with a blank expression. No other effects for 2 hours 49 minutes of exposure. Exposure, beta. At 2 hours 50 minutes, subject's body started to contort in random directions, while he stated that he was experiencing great pain. The subject's skull increased in mass and size, though the suit continued to confine the patient. Subject's body began to increase dramatically in mass, although body growth was not symmetrical. Observers noticed the subject's mouth and eyes began to bulge and deform beneath the mask of the suit. Subject then slammed his body against the testing cage, screaming incoherently while attempting to make eye contact with as many observers as possible. Termination order was executed at 34 minutes after time point beta was reached. Notes: subject's body was determined to have increased in mass by nearly 180% as of termination. Most of the increase was bone and muscle tissue. While no external source has been found to explain this growth, several genetic samples had abnormally shortened telomere strands. Observers also reported an unnatural feeling that precluded normal movement whenever eye contact with the mutated subject was made, suggesting full mimetic security precautions in place for all future testing. Test number 2. Subject gender: male. Subject's known mental illness: paranoid personality disorder. Medication: exposure alpha. Subject reported being, quote, quiet in his head, end quote. Subject was noted as whirling his head around, exclaiming, "God damn, this is better than the shit you gave me. I can't hear them anymore." Subject was then removed from SCP-482 after 2 hours of exposure. Subject then expressed a desire to return to the suit. Subject became increasingly agitated and eventually became violent when his requests were denied. After 30 minutes, Dr. approved the subject's return to the suit. Subject returned to the previously calm state for 1 hour and 30 minutes. Exposure, beta. At 3 hours 30 minutes, subject apparently reached point beta. Mutation began manifesting at this point. Visible bulges appeared beneath the surface of the suit around the head, neck, and shoulder area. Since the subject was fully enclosed, it was initially impossible to determine the nature of these bulges. 4 minutes after the bulges appeared, subject was heard to exclaim, "Stop talking! Get out of my head!" consistent with extreme instances of paranoia. Bulges then began to spread down the length of the body as well at 15 minutes after mutations began. At this point, audio recorded at least 7 distinct sounds that analysts indicate could be voices speaking an unknown language. Termination order was given at 25 minutes after point beta had been passed. Notes: autopsy indicates that each bulge that manifested beneath the suit was a fully formed mouth, at least 6 millimeters across, with small channels to the lung system and voice boxes, so that the mouths could speak. Future review of tapes shows small shadows appearing and disappearing indistinctly throughout the recording. Researchers questioned about this confirmed that on review of their experience, they remember seeing movement in their peripheral vision, but at the time, were focused on the subject, so did not note the experience. All future tests should have follow-up interviews with researchers 24 hours, 3 days, and 2 weeks after testing, for potential lasting mimetic effects. Dr. Test number 3. Subject gender: male. Subject's known mental illness: satyriasis. Medication: none. Exposure alpha. Subject reported being, quote, unable to get a boner, end quote. Subject displayed signs of minor lethargy and lack of initiative in performing anything beyond sitting and looking around. Media of sexual nature was displayed to the subject, who expressed lack of interest in them. No other reactions were noted at this time. Initial stage lasted 3 hours 17 minutes. Exposure beta. At 3 hours 18 minutes, subject started shuddering and began to spasm repeatedly. These reactions started occurring in increasing frequency and duration. At 3 hours 39 minutes, subject began convulsing violently, and started expelling a white fluid from his mouth, visible to outside observers through the suit's mask. Termination order was given at 3 hours and 45 minutes after initial reactions observed. Notes: the autopsy revealed that the subject's whole body, while physically unchanged outside, had been converted inside into a series of linked organs that allowed the subject to create massive amounts of sperm and release it via existing orifices at a high rate. Initial spasms and convulsions were apparently a series of near-continuous orgasms suffered by the patient. The expelled semen began exiting the body through all major orifices, and the autopsy also shows that channels were forming beneath the subject's skin, perhaps eventually leading to expelling of the seminal fluid through the pores as well. It is theorized by researcher M that the severity of the subject's satyriasis may be a factor in its mutation rate. Testing on the collected seminal fluid indicated that it was completely sterile. Observers reported during post-observation interviews that they have become aroused more easily than normal. This effect appears to have worn off after days. The suit does appear to be immune to any physical changes caused to the subject, but anything expelled from the subject does not magically disappear, people. With results like these, the suit should be fully cleaned and sterilized after every use. Dr. Test number 4. Subject gender: female. Subject's known mental illness: hyperphagia. Medication: exposure alpha. Subject was offered a full 7-course meal with feeding assistance from researchers. Subject refused the offer, stating that, "For the first time ever, I'm actually full." Subject conversed about various topics with researchers and otherwise ignored offers for food. No other reactions were noted for 1 hour 58 minutes. Exposure beta: at 1 hour 59 minutes after initial exposure, subject indicated a dull pain in her midsection, centering around her stomach. Pain intensity began to increase as the experiment continued. The subject's extremities apparently began to retract into her body, though the suit continued to conform to her new body's shape. Subject curled up in a fetal position, stating that she was in intense pain, and saying, "Oh God, it's eating me! Oh God, it hurts!" Limbs began to retract inward with a loud snapping sound at 15 minutes past manifestation of symptoms, whereupon Dr. issued the termination order. Notes: the autopsy indicates that a separate, fully functional digestive system had formed in the subject's body and began consuming the subject's body mass. This system seemed to utilize the subject's own flesh, bone, and fluids to add to its own mass. Dr. theorizes that, left unchecked, this organ structure would have potentially consumed the subject's entire body mass. Following this test, observers reported being unable to satisfy hunger cravings with normal volumes of food. Researchers M and R proceeded to consume several kilograms of food from the Foundation cafeteria before security stopped them. These urges faded days after exposure. Test number 5. Subject gender: male. Subject's known mental illness: Capgras syndrome. Medication: exposure alpha. Due to violent behavior, subject was tranquilized prior to the experiment. Subject returned to full consciousness at 17 minutes after donning SCP-482, whereupon he began to rant about a variety of topics that his attending physician noted as the basis for his delusions. However, ranting subsided after several minutes, replaced with utter calm. Subject was heard to exclaim, "Huh? What's going on?" No other reactions were noted for 4 hours 54 minutes. Exposure beta: upon entering point beta, subject displayed rapid skin and muscular mutation. Subject's eyes began to bulge noticeably, and recording devices showed what appeared to be text scrolling across the subject's eyes. Subject began facing each researcher in turn and taking exaggerated breaths. Subject struggled against confinement and began to cry out, "I knew it. There's no way you're real. You've kept them from me. Their smell isn't right. They must be in hiding." Subject continued to rant for 48 minutes, at which point, the termination order was given. Notes: Autopsy revealed that the subject's nervous system pathways had increased in size by percent. The subject's tongue showed an increase in taste buds by percent, and new formations in the eyes had developed. The subject's brain had also increased in mass by percent, with a 5 times greater density of neural transmitters and conductors. Testing on the formations in the subject's eyes indicate that the subject likely had visual acuity that extended into both the ultraviolet and infrared ranges. Dr. postulates that the increase in sensory information and nerve clusters allowed the subject to test every possible type of input to try and prove that individuals were real and not imposters. Testing is proceeding on extracted nerve sections to determine if we can duplicate their growth and increased density as a basis for potential transplant. After testing, observers indicated a heightened sense of hearing and perception for days, accompanied by an increased sense of paranoia. Test number 6. Subject gender, male. Subject's known mental illness, pyromania. Medication, none. Exposure alpha, data expunged. Subject ignored flammable materials offered by researchers for 1 hour 32 minutes. Exposure beta, at 1 hour 33 minutes, testing instruments recorded an increase in ambient room temperature to data expunged. Suffered containment failure at data expunged. Recorded temperatures upwards of Kelvin and spontaneously ignited data expunged. Loss of all observers and caused catastrophic damage to hallway A13 at site before containment was re-established. The suit was recovered unharmed. Notes: the subject's body recovered showed increased density and had magnetic properties that made autopsy difficult. It also retained heat upwards of Kelvin. Dissection showed a new organ in the body that was sustaining a data expunged and appeared stable. The organ was removed and placed in storage in magnetic containment at site for future analysis. Despite the loss of resources and personnel due to this experiment, something productive came from it. If we can figure out how this organ is still containing, then we may open a new avenue of research. Dr. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-481, Scar Tissue, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.